Lady Red. Where the hell are we? Oh. And why are we all tied up in some spooky basement? Oh. It's you.
Hey Qween season 5 is not gonna happen. Terrible. Overrated. Just like Meryl Streep. Right, Melania?
Yes?
I'm here to make America great again.
Well, our job is to make America gay again, so you need to let us go!
Yeah, let us go!
Yeah!
I'm gonna build a wall between you and the internet.
Girl, look how orange you look!
Yeah, you crusted, tiny-handed, Cheeto-faced motherfucker! Let us go!
Never.
Lady Red, I think it's time to activate.
Wonder Twin Powers, activate!
Category is...
Kicking your ass!
Oh! Oh, Melania, grab her by the pussy!
I said be knocked out! Oh.
Children, are you ready for some cutting up and kikiing? Are you ready for a gay old time? Well, I hope you are, because now it's time for season 5 premiere of Hey Qween with your host, Jonny McGovern!
Hey Qween, come on and spill the tea. Hey Qween, it's just a good old fashioned kiki. Hey Qween, we're cutting up with Jonny.
Delicious little fruit loops, and welcome to the spectacular season 5 premiere of Hey Qween! Yay! Yes, honey! With me, your host, Jonny McGovern. Ooh, today's show is going to be legendary, darling. We have a Hall of Famer in the house. The Stunique. Yeah, I said it. Stunique. That's stunning and unique. Miss Alaska Thunderfuck is in the building. Yeah. Yes. The winner of All Stars 2, honey. The winner of our hearts. But before she comes out here, there is someone else who is always slaying the children. She's the thunder to my lightning. She could be Little Pound Cake's drag mother. Lots of pound cake. And if there were a 51st state, it would be her. Miss Lady Regator. Yay!
Yeah.
Honey.
How are you?
Well, how are you?
I'm doing good.
Welcome to our new set, Lady Red.
So glamour.
I mean, every year we try to be like, what if Barbie's dream house threw up? And this is what we like, and now it's really getting there. Pink, purple, sparkles.
So beautiful.
And in our tradition, darling, you're wearing the couch from last season
as a dress. Of course, of course.
Yes.
I look like Cleopatra.
Oh, yes, you do. You look very rich.
A little bipolar, you know what I mean? Because I'll be like, oh, gold, no, blue, no.
Oh.
Pink.
Oh.
Gold.
Oh. Sparkled as hell.
She's having a good time.
Looking good.
Smelling like fruits and flowers and all kind of shit.
Oh, okay. And I look like a Pepto-Bismol bottle.
Yeah.
A very sexy Pepto-Bismol bottle. Oh, yeah. I want to get inside you. And fix your indigestion.
So
wait, is that a small little bird over there? Who's that over there?
Uh-oh.
Mr. Adam Joseph and the Go to Bed Wigs.
Oh,
yes.
Yeah.
Oh, boy. Well, honey, we got a very big show today. Oh. The winner of All Stars 2, honey.
Oh, my God.
The woman whose album, Pound Cake, has been slaying them everywhere.
Slaying,
murdering, slitting their throats. And who'll be joining you on the Drag Queens of Comedy Tour.
Yay!
Yes! Honey, you know what I'm talking about. Miss Alaska Thunderfuck is here!
Yay!
Be with her right after this very gay break. Adam, take us out.
Alaska, she's the one. All-Star 2 champion. Alaska, spill the tea. Alaska's own Hey Qween.
Yeah!
Hey Qween.
Here at Hey Qween, we love drag. We've assembled a panel of drag experts to help up-and-coming queens pimp their drag.
Pimp my drag. Pimp my drag. Pimp my drag. Pimp my drag. Pimp my drag.
I'm spilling the tea. It's gonna be hot, hot, hot.
It's Hey Qween Hot Tea, the show where we sip steaming hot celebrity lies and throw Hollywood shade. I'm your host, Mr. Jonny McGovern, with my favorite hilarious people, Julie Goldman,
Lady Red Couture,
the beautiful Brandy Howard.
Yes. Oh my God, it's so hot I don't want to touch it, but I just can't resist.
Real Housewives, real plastic surgery.
Richard Simmons transition.
She looks like Kelly Osbourne.
Trixie Mattel.
Yeah.
Manila Luzon.
Yeah. Yes.
Brandy Bannon's boyfriend is
Callum Best.
Obviously, he's good at what he does because he's fucked the best of the best.
Kylie, Chloe, and Kim have not gotten near a white dick since junior high.
Release the Kraken!
I cannot deal with that at all. I will go crazy. It's making me crazy right now. And now I'm insane.
Oh, but if you want the tea, honey, the total tea, girl. No O's, honey, the tea.
Hey, Qween!
Yeah, Kiki! We are back. The season 5 premiere continues. Now, let me tell you, this queen has had quite the last couple years, but last year was one of her biggest. She won All Stars 2. She turned into a snake, turned back into a from a snake. She won everyone's hearts back again. She released a huge album. She's been on tour. She's been around the world. And finally, she is here with us today. Everybody, please give a warm Hey Qween welcome to Alaska Thunderfuck. Drapes okay. Carefully, right. Darling.
I can do it.
Oh, you need me to hold your scepter for a second?
No,
you
got, absolutely not.
Never.
Absolutely not.
Never. Okay. Those kids, Alaska, no wonder you had to tiptoe over here, those shoes. Can we please get a shot of the gigantic Alaska shoes? Wow. Yeah. Give it up for Alaska one more time, everybody.
Sweetheart. Hi.
Look at her. Look at all of her.
Hiya.
Honey, how are you? You look, wait, what do these nails say?
They say like various catchphrases.
Oh.
Like, absolutely.
They were actually made for Gia Gunn.
Oh, really? Yeah. Oh, yeah, because they say Gia Gunn on them.
They say Gia Gunn, they say absolutely, they say stun.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Well, welcome back, Queen Alaska. I'm so happy you brought your crown and your scepter, honey.
Girl, of course.
Hard earned, well earned.
Thank you.
Yes, I mean, come on.
Thank you.
Do you now wear the crown and take the scepter everywhere you go?
I do. Grocery store, bank.
Everywhere.
Girl.
Into the Uber. Like, I'm going to need room for this. I need an Uber XL.
Girl,
I got
exactly.
My crown.
SUV.
SUV only.
No, Lyft SUV now.
Oh,
no,
right. Uber. Of course.
Yeah, totally.
That's right. That's right.
Lyft Plus.
And your hair today is giving me just Barbie, just beachy waves.
Right. I just rolled out of bed.
Exactly.
Fresh out of the, yeah.
Just a little.
Hair dry.
Let it fluff up.
Looking
good.
Wet and wavy. Just natural. You know, I can't be bothered with wigs.
No, not at all.
Girls do that.
Your hair is just naturally gorgeous.
Some girls do that.
And you're wearing yourself today.
I am. Isn't this beautiful? It's a Magnus Hastings shower curtain. Because I didn't have any clothes.
You didn't have any clothes.
I was like, what do I wear? Last night, we got back really late.
Because you were shooting the video for Stan.
Wait, where's the camera? Which one is
that? That one. They're right there.
Stan. we were doing the music, and that's why I'm wearing Gia's nails, because she already had, like, a full set,
and so she couldn't use them.
And I lost, like, 8 of mine in the process of doing it, so I was like, I'm stealing hers.
Why not?
No clothes. We took this off the wall. I had it up as, like, a thing, and now I have clothes.
You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Lady Red, your duet partner from Let's Do Drag
Hello.
Is here. Yes.
Let's
I'm
do
so
drag.
Happy to see her, honey, serving nothing but body, oddy, oddy, and fishiness.
What can we expect from the stun video, honey?
Looks, beauty. It was amazing.
Gagatry?
Gagatry of stanikness.
Of you, gagatry of stanikness, exactly.
It's a really fun video. Mm. I'm really excited.
The videos have just been so amazing.
Thank you.
The little pound cake, the puppet video, so good. Mm-hmm. I mean, how long does a video shoot take? Like, this one was just last night, right? Did you shoot all day?
Yeah, I like to do them in one day, and usually it can be done in one day. It's a long day, but it can be done in one day.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is there going to be a Lady Red Alaska video for Let's Do Drag?
We were just talking about it over there, and, and I think we definitely need to do it.
Yes.
Because you're so stunning, Lady Red. And,
you're so nice to me. I'm glad your cataracts worked out.
Girl, seriously, like... I want to do it. I think we should do it.
What was that day in the studio like when you guys did that duet?
It was amazing. I called up Lady Red. No, it was something happened, though. It was like...
Okay, wait. Remember, you know I smoke a lot of weed.
I mean...
So she said to me, okay, we're going to go and do it on this date. And I said, yes, okay, we're going to do it on that date.
Yeah.
And then I was smoking weed all day.
Right.
And she called me, and I was like... Hello? And she's like, this is Alaska. And I'm like, hey, girl, what's up? And she's like, well, girl, it's time to do the bit. It's time to do the song. And I said, do the song? What the fuck? So I said, okay. So then she got me a lift, and we went up there and did it, honey. And she wore me out. And, we talked a little bit because I had to get my mind right.
Yeah.
I do remember that day. Lady Red said, ooh, bitch.
I know.
I forgot I had to do a song with Alaska today. I'm like, I'm glad your only words in the song were, ah! So that's good. That helped out. You didn't have to learn nothing. Just had to do you.
Yeah.
Had to do me.
And she just slayed it so hard. And that's one of my favorites. I do that song, like, as the opening, like, when I'm on the road.
Yeah.
And I try and sing Lady Red's part, but it's really high. It's such a that, ah! I can't even do it. On stage, I can do it. I think I can, anyway. I'm so glad I'm here.
Honey. Now, let's talk a few things before we get into the deepness.
Can I set this down?
Set it down.
Do you want to try it? Hold it. It's really heavy.
Oh, my God.
It's really heavy.
Finally.
The power!
Now I have the power! I turn into Skeletor. I alone can defeat Alaska. Adam, are you giving me opulence right now? Do it again.
Lightning.
O-P-U-L-E-N-C-E. Opulence. You own everything.
Everything is yours.
Exactly. Thank you. Please, you take it. You've so rightly earned this back.
Can I set it here?
Yeah, so we lightly just set it on the desk. Yeah. Oh, it'll look so beautiful and sparkly. Well, girl, this scepter here was very hard won, darling.
Yeah.
You really got to that fucking show, and you came to win, and I want to go into it. Are you ready for that?
Girl, let's go in.
Let's go. Are you
go
ready for that,
deeply
audience?
And
so let's start soft from the very beginning.
It's a very good place to
start. So they, of course, only call you, like, what, 2 weeks before it's time?
Yeah, it's quick.
And had you been kind of, like, getting wafts of the fact that maybe All-Stars was coming? Did they say you're going to be on it, but we don't know when it's going to start?
I knew as much as anyone else did. So it was like, RuPaul says in an interview,
right?
Sure, I would do a second All-Stars.
Yeah, so
and then
she
the
said
internet's
that in this
like,
interview.
It's happening. It's confirmed. Right. But
start
no.
Hashtagging. Everyone's trying to get on it.
No one knew when or why or who or anything.
Right.
But then it was like we finally got the call, and it was like, all right, now we need to like start getting ready.
Do it. And so what's the first thing you do? So are you calling for outfits? Are you figuring out what you're gonna do? You get a list of vague challenges.
Yeah, they tell you like an assignment list. Like these are looks that you should bring.
Right.
And am I supposed to say? I'm allowed to say that. Whatever.
You already won, bitch. You already won.
Right. And the first thing I did was call my friend Dallas Coulter in San Francisco because she knows she makes a lot of my clothes.
Right. So you're like, start bringing the looks.
She was the first text and phone call.
Put the children in the sweatshop and let it begin. So you're thinking, now are you thinking like, what am I going to do for Snatch Game? Am I going to be a golden girl for Snatch Game? Am I going to be... Because you had originally thought, like, maybe I'll do Blanche Devereaux, right?
Yeah. Got me feeling like Blanche Devereaux.
Got me acting like a real big
Blanche Devereaux.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Yes!
I love that you know that. Thank you, Alaska.
Thank you for being such a big fucking... Oh, my God. I thought you were so good.
You're the best. So you were thinking maybe Blanche Devereaux.
Yeah.
But then you were like, that's fictional. So.
Yeah, you can't do a fictional character, you can't do cartoon characters.
Uh-huh.
So it was like, I could do Rue McClanahan, I mean, I could have, but it was like, and then we were watching, at the time, we were obsessed with Mae West and like watching old clips of her, and like, she's in the movie Myra Breckinridge.
Yeah.
And she was like 90,
uh-huh.
But she was still being Mae West, like, I'm sexy.
Yeah, exactly.
90. Just they're propping her up in the doorway to stand there and be like, come on up and fuck me.
She was literally embalmed in that movie.
Literally.
Like, so old.
She's like, they're carrying her out on a couch, like 100 dudes dancing, and she's like, you're gonna taste all the fruit. And we were just obsessed with this clip, and so we were like, why don't you just do her?
Yeah.
And so I did her.
So you did. So you started watching your Myra Breckinridge. You got your outfits together.
Like, just Google her top catchphrases.
Right.
Because she
that's
had
the
catchphrases
key. Yeah.
Like a rude girl.
Uh-huh. She sure did.
I was just working it. Yeah.
So then you arrive. You fly in. You arrive. You come into the... You get there. You're sequestered away.
I was living in L.A., though, so I didn't fly this time.
Oh, right. So you were
here. A van came to my house.
Right. A pink fan covered in RuPaul being like, win.
We'll say that's a, no, it was
right,
a white unmarked.
An unmarked vehicle.
Van.
Top secret.
Yeah, girl.
So now, are you in the hotel the first night trying to put a glass to the wall?
A little
bit. To hear, be like, who could it be? Who might it be?
Yeah.
Who is my big competition?
Yeah, because they have to get all the queens from across the country. You know, so you're there for a couple days.
Oh, you're there for a couple days before you start.
You don't have any contact except with like a couple people on the Drag Race staff. They've taken the phone out of your hotel room, so you can't even call the front desk.
Sheesh.
And yeah, it's sort of like we're like, who's in the room next to me?
Yeah.
I know someone is because I hear them talking to them. But yeah, I think Coco Montrese was in the room next to me.
Because you kept hearing, I'm not joking, bitch. I wanted bacon with my eggs, bitch.
Exactly.
Thank you. My Coco Montrese is legendary.
Yeah, you can do her on Snatch Game, girl.
I will. Yeah. I will when they do a big bearded queen edition.
Yeah. Confirmed. It's happening.
Confirmed,
tweet
it's
it.
Happening.
Tweet it.
Everyone's there.
Confirmed.
Tweet it. Out. They're doing a man version.
The category is Butch Queen, first time in drags at a ball.
You know.
So you get there. They finally get you over to the whole studio. You come in the workroom. Now, what are your thoughts when the queens are coming in? Were you nervous? Were you thinking, okay, this bitch is my real competition. This bitch I can get. This bitch, like, what was your mind frame on that first day?
I wanted to take up as much room in the room as possible because that's like an intimidation tactic.
Oh, yes,
Queen
bitch.
Queen of Snakes.
Queen of Snakes.
So I built this thing out of just tied off trash bags and taped them together one after the other to create this huge thing so no one could get close to me.
Right.
And I would take up the whole room.
My goodness.
But no, it was great. It was very just like seeing a bunch of your friends.
Yeah. Because you know all these girls.
Yeah. And then the gag was Tatiana because we were all like, what?
Oh, right.
She's here. That was the gag.
Mm-hmm.
We were all gagged.
When you guys realized, what about the gag of you guys realizing you're going to be eliminating each other?
That was terrible. Because the first day RuPaul came in the workroom and was like, I won't be sending home anyone.
Right.
And we just believed that.
Was there a moment of like, what, you guys, we're all stars, we're gonna have fun, there's no elimination?
That's what we thought. We were like, oh, it makes sense. They can keep us all, they can see what we do. There's
right.
only 10 of us.
Yeah.
Like, we can just put out a really good show and then the winner who gets the most points wins. Like, we literally thought that was what it was gonna be. And then the next day on the runway, she's like, you're sending home each other. And then we all cried, and it was like judgment at Nuremberg.
Judgment at Nuremberg, honey.
It was horrible.
That first judges panel, the knives came out, darling.
Oh, my God.
And luckily, are you
reliving
the... you're like, my boobs are making all
my breasts are escaping my body at the very mention of this
experience. We did this once already. We gotta go. See ya, bye. Ring, ding, 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 ding. So that first night, you were safe, but you got to witness the slaughteration of Adore Delano. And that was pretty brutal.
Yeah, it was.
Or did you really think it was not as brutal as was the reaction?
No, it was. And I know that. And the thing is, Michelle Visage is like a mother to every single one of us. And
yeah.
We've been on tour with her.
A lot. Y'all have spent a lot of time with her.
Like, she's our friend.
Yeah.
And so, going back in, she had to establish herself as, here, we're not friends, bitch.
Yeah.
I'm this woman sitting behind the desk, and it is my job to read you for filth.
Uh-huh.
What would the show be if she wasn't there to do that?
Right.
It would be like, ki-ki-ki, la-la-la. She had to establish herself as, like, I'm not joking, bitch.
Exactly.
And so that's what it was. And so Adore was the first one, and it was the first time Michelle... So she had to go in, and she went in on everybody.
Oof, boy.
And, you know...
Yeah, thank you, Adam. That's exactly what we needed. So then Adore decides to leave. Were you shocked, or were you like, and... pack your bags, bitch. Like, what were your thoughts?
Well, I of course was happy because it was one less person in the competition.
Right.
So it's closer to the end.
Mm.
So of course, that's great.
Yeah.
However, Adora's my friend and she was going through it and I was like, I don't want you to like regret doing that.
Right.
I wanted her to stay. I thought she should have, but no, I mean it worked out for her. She was like, fuck, I don't want to stand on this fucking
stage and get critiqued like that. Like,
that's definitely a different experience. You guys, like, when you first did the show, most of everybody was pretty unknown. And then you spend the years or whatever literally touring five nights a week where everyone's screaming for you, loving you. Yeah. No matter what you do, you're perfect and wonderful. And suddenly it's like back to the judgment.
Yeah. And it's like Adore Delano's a working, successful, brilliant artist.
Pop star. Yeah.
She doesn't have to stand on a stage and get told what's wrong with her.
Right.
You know, and so she was like, I don't want to put myself through it. Like, I understand. I understand.
But you were not there. You were ready to do whatever it took to get this motherfucking crown.
Because I'm obsessed with Drag Race, and I was obsessed with winning Drag Race All-Stars.
Yes.
And so I was like, yes, I will stand up here, and I will get critiqued, and I will have a LaGanja breakdown, and I will do everything there is to... Oh, my God, that just happened.
What happened? Yo, Jules!
As soon as I said LaGanja's name. It's okay.
It's feeling very attacked. It's very beautiful.
Chloe Sampson
made
it.
But it was feeling very attacked, along with your boobs and the scepter.
It broke. It's secured with a safety pin because it broke when I fell on the sidewalk earlier.
You fell on the sidewalk earlier?
We were walking from the 8 feet from the SUV to the here.
Right. In your 8-inch hooker shoes, just, like your old song used to say.
I was like, if Lady Gaga could do the Victoria's Secret fashion show in these shoes, I can walk from here to there. Walk and just toppled, and my neck muscles bulged like this and burst the choker off. Whatever, the shoes are cool.
The shoes are cool. You look cool. Yes. If you ever need to kick somebody's ass, just take that shoe off. Ray Lynn, I'm getting you a pair of those for Christmas.
I wish you would. Hey, Qween!